Have you heard about Anchor by Spotify? It's the easiest way to make a podcast. It has everything you need all in one place. Anchor has tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or computer. You can then distribute your podcast on listening platforms like Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Play, and more. I use it to host a Crotch Shot radio show. It has everything I need to make a great podcast, and best of all, Anchor is totally free. Download the Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started today.
Guys, and light the fires. Let's do this. Warning.
This show contains mature content. Listener discretion is advised.
Are you ready to get your mind blown?
Decided to start a radio show, determined to piss the world off by shoving a mirror in front of society's face and kick them in the balls.
What are you? Who are you?
This is the Crotch Shot Radio Show. Crotch Shot Radio Show.
This is not a test. This is a broadcast transmission.
We're going to stay on the air.
And now, the weepy, the weepy.
Welcome to the Crotch Shot Radio Show, where we kick the issues in the balls. We are on an active war against bullshit. We would do anything and everything to expose bullshit. The ends sometimes justify the memes. So if you're angry and want the truth exposed, then strap in and prepare to be shocked. This is Smash Mouth Talk. If you can't accept that, then fuck off. I'm your host, Louis B. I takes no bullshit from nobody. I actually expose the bullshit of the society and chop it up into easy-to-digest chunks for you. Today won't be any different. Today, we are going to be talking about why, going to be talking about how the LGBTQ, aka Alphabet Mafia, and third wave feminism is constantly on the attack to destroy masculinity. It's something that they've always done. And I'm just going to be talking about this this article that was sent to me. This was written back in 1983. So 38 years ago, this retardation was started, I guess, and it keeps getting perpetuated. So I'm going to read this. This is from an excerpt from Essays in Feminist Theory, meaning how to pull shit out your ass. So we got, so if you guys want to join the show, I am streaming live on Twitch. In fact, hold on, I'm streaming live on Twitch. Go to twitch.tv/LouisB, or you go to dlive.tv/LouisB1, or go to Trovo. Trovo.live/LouisB1, or you could go on my site, crotchoutradio.xyz/live. If you guys want to call into the show, the number is 347-927-6824. So, back to this excerpt from a book called The Politics of Reality, an excerpt from Essays in Feminist Theory by Marilyn Frye. Back in 1983, basically trying, like, okay, well, let me just read this shit. To say that straight men are heterosexual is only to say that they engage in sex exclusively with the other sex, i.e. women. almost all of that which pertains to love, most straight men reserve exclusively for other men. Yeah. Yeah. The people from whom they admire, respect, adore, revere, honor, who they imitate, idolize, and form profound attachments to, whom they are willing to teach, and from whom they are willing to learn, and whose respect, admiration, recognition, honor, reverence, and love they desire. Those are overwhelmingly other men. In their relations with women, what passes for respect is kindness, generosity, or paternalism. That passes for honor is removal to the pedestal. From women, they want devotion, service, and sex. Heterosexual men culture is homoerotic. It's man loving. See, why is it that, you know, men having goodness, I don't even want to use the term relationships, because that's kind of like friendships, camaraderie, you know, these are men that you form bonds with, that, hey, this is a dude that is going to be in the foxhole with you, that's going to help you kill the enemy, that's going to help you protect your family, help you protect your tribe. Like, I mean, of course, I was talking to my god sister. She's like, well, you know, the Romans were gay and they would fuck each other. Yeah, and that's why how Rome fell. Because they were all a bunch of homos. I mean, come on. That's why it fell. That's part of the reason why it fell. I mean, that's part of the reason why this country is starting to crumble. Because, I mean, look, I hate to sound like this. Because, look, I know a lot of great gay men. But, I mean, the soft motherfuckers that we got now, the ones that want to change their gender every 10 seconds, whenever they're in trouble, the first thing they do is they want to change their gender like they're Power Rangers. It's like, oh shit, I'm in trouble, I'm a her, bitch, you know, like, what the fuck? It's like, Oh shit, it's transgender time. Female. Like, what the fuck? It's like that's exactly what the fuck they do. But then men who form groups, who form fraternal orders, men who like, you know, of course you're going to respect your buddy. A lot of the things that I have learned, a lot of the life lessons I have learned were from men. Doesn't mean I, you know, like, I mean, of course there's going to be some form of respect from the person that teaches you. There's a form of respect. There's a form of trust. And look, this is going to sound, I don't know, this is going to sound fucking woman-hating. I'm not trying to sound like a fucking woman-hater, but most of the time when you listen to women, guys end up fucking dead. I mean, really think about it. Adam listened to Eve. The fuck happened? We're no longer in paradise. We're no longer in the Garden of Eden. Dumbass listened to Eve. If I was Adam, I would have been like, you ate from the tree, you dumb bitch. God, can you make me another woman, please? Oh, you can? Sayonara, bitch. Die. Anyways, that would have been me. But, you know, we're going to be like God? Oh, shit. Okay, let me get a bite of that. Like, what the fuck? I mean, look at recent history. Anytime a man has listened to a woman over some inane bullshit, oh, he grabbed my ass. Oh, he said something bad about me. Like what happened in New York a few weeks ago where that Latin guy stabbed the black dude in the throat because his woman decided to tell him, oh, he disrespected me. He didn't let me steal a bag of chips. So he went around, tried to kill the old Spanish guy. And the Spanish guy was like, abracadabra, here's a knife. Gah! Goodbye. He died because he wants to listen to his chick. Tell me why. At this point, like I keep hearing this, like, oh, well, we keep you alive. We keep you alive. No, you don't. Most of the things we have in the West were built by men. The skyscrapers were built by men. If you remove all men, this whole society collapses. Because I don't see women going into the sewer doing anything. I don't see women wanting to fucking work power stations. I don't see women wanting to do the dirty jobs. The trash is going to get stacked up in the kitchen. I mean, hell, if there were no men, they just all turn into hairy beasts because they're like, oh, I'm not shaving. What am I going to be shaving for? Going to have a whole bunch of Wookiees if there were no men on this planet. Oh, we can have bone marrow babies. Okay, have some retard kids. All right, by all means. But the fact that I have a commodity with another man doesn't mean it's gay. I mean, that's the thing. They try to push this gay shit on people. Like, if you're naturally gay, God bless. But don't be like, oh, you like the way Superman holds it. Like, I read this article. The way Superman is drawn, where he has his hands on his hips, proves that he's gay. Like, what the fuck? Like, why do they have to take everything from us? Oh, well, he likes to hang out with his buddies. He's gay. Like, honestly, let me play that thing by Patrice O'Neal. Like, Patrice is always the goat when it let me see. Okay, here it is. In fact, he said this shit perfectly. Oops, let me share screen. Again, if you guys want to watch, it is twitch.tv/LouisB. Just look for Louis B and you'll see. Here it is. Share.
You ever feel like a terrible person when you're watching the news? Like you're watching the news and no matter what's on, you just can't care. Like you try to, but it just... 30,000 Chinese people died in an earthquake. And you're like, oh my God. Oh, wow. I could care less. Oh my God. A missing mother of 10 hasn't been seen in 2 weeks. You're like, all right, I'm gonna care about this. I know it. I know. Oh, wow. I don't give a damn. Like, I mean, I believe in God, but, I'm not deep into religion. Like, I'm too afraid to not believe in God, you know? Like, I'm not an atheist. I'm, like, before that, like, I believe in God when I'm on planes. Like, I really believe in God. You ever try to make a side deal with God? Just when I get on planes, I look at some old lady struggling with her bags, having trouble putting it in overhead. And I'm like, wait a minute, lady, let me get that for you, ma'am. Let me put that heavy bag up there for you, because, look, God, Look what a great guy I am helping this woman with her bags. You ain't gonna let the plane crash, are you, Lord Jesus? Because I'm a good person. And then when the plane lands, the lady's looking at me like, you want to get my bags? I'm like, no, like what? I kept the plane in the air, you selfish bitch. I don't even believe in ground karma. I kept us all alive. Let somebody else handle the ground. I'm not getting it. It's hard to be honest, man. Honesty is not the greatest thing to be. It's not, it's just no one wants to hear, yeah. Especially your woman, you know, she don't want to hear that. You ever have your girlfriend or your wife call you from another room and she's like, sweetie, and then like immediately you go, your stomach just goes, oh. Oh, what does she want? Oh, this is gonna suck, I know it. It's not gonna be good, because it's never good. You want to hear what happened to me today? He'd be like, oh, not really. I always make my girlfriend tell me the end of any story she get ready to tell me first before I invest in the whole. I'd be like, shut up. What's the end of the story? Like, somebody got shot. All right, go ahead. Try to tell a story. She starts off wrong all the time. You know my friend Diane, right? And here's why I mess up. I go, nah, I don't know Diane. You know Diane. Now I gotta tell you an hour and a half side story about who Diane is. Because I can't keep going with the story till you know who Diane is. Remember 3 years ago I made you go to a party that you didn't want to go to? Or was it 2 years ago? Wait a minute, was it 2 years ago I made you go to Diane? No, it was 3 years ago I made you go. And remember I introduced you to a bunch of women you didn't care about? One of them was Diane. You remember now? Don't do this. Yeah, I remember. You don't remember, you're just saying that so I can tell the story faster. Well, why don't you tell the story faster? Who got shot? Did Diane get shot? She didn't get shot. Did she shoot somebody? She didn't shoot. Why'd you say Diane? Because she don't like guns. Why would you say that? Finish the story. Who got shot?
Never mind now. You won't let me tell the story the way I want to tell the story. So I won't finish because you won't let me tell it with Diane, my friend who doesn't like guns and stuff. Hey.
Hey, I'm sorry, ladies. That's not y'all. That's some other ladies that's not in here. I don't even know what women that could possibly be. You want to know how to, because men, it's hard for us to love you and like you at the same time. It's just, it is what it is. Once a man loves you, he no longer likes you usually. So I'm going to give you some advice, ladies, on how to keep your man liking you once he loves you, if that's possible. This is what I think. Men want to be alone, but we don't want to be by ourselves. Does that make sense at all? Meaning, really, look at this guy looking at his wife like, not you, sweetie, but sort of you, kind of. We want you somewhere, like, in the dwelling, just not here, like just like around the corner, in the vents. You can sit in the vent, I don't care if you wanna watch me, but in the on the roof, anywhere, but just not in front of me, trying to be my friend. What you doing? What you doing? Watching baseball? Why are you watching baseball by yourself? How come you didn't get me up? You snuck out of bed. Why'd you didn't get me up? I wanna watch baseball with you. What you doing? Why you down here by yourself? Move over, move your leg off that ottoman where it's comfortable so I can sit next to you and wrap my leg around your leg and some weird, I love you, hot vine. Move over, give me your arm. Give me your arm, give it to me. Let me give it, come here. Give me a kiss. Mean it, mean the kiss. You love me? Say it. Say it. Mean it. What you doing? What you eating? A hamburger? You shouldn't be eating a hamburger at 11. It's too early to eat a hamburger. Let me go make you a better sandwich, a turkey sandwich on 47 grain bread with no mayonnaise and bean sprouts. Tastes like rat turds and twigs. Ain't that better? Ain't that better? A dry sandwich you don't want? Ain't that better? Why is the TV so loud? Well, turn it down. Ain't that better? Can't hear the TV. Got a dry sandwich you don't want? Ain't that better? Why is it so cold in here? Why is the ceiling fan and the air conditioner? Turn it off. Ain't that better? Sweating, wrapped up into a hot vine. Can't hear the TV. Got a dry sandwich. Ain't that better? Why is it so dark in here? Let some sunlight in. Ain't that better? Can't see the TV. Can't hear it. Hey, I gotta go, man. Y'all take care, man. Thank you very much.
Full screen. Hey, what's up? I mean, Patrice will forever be the GOAT. But then you have these throwaway feminists writing this shit. It's like, they just don't want men to congregate. They're like, what are they doing? What are they planning? Because if we don't congregate, if we don't like work together, if we don't form positive male bonds, they could be like, well, you know, honey, why don't you paint your toenails? Honey, why don't you fucking wear this dress? Oh, it doesn't mean you're gay. They try to like feminize men. But the thing is, a stone is sharpened by other stone. You know, you form male bonds. You learn. It's just you learn, it's like you keep that sense of community. You have your tribe. You're around a fellow warriors. Like, okay, these are the guys that you're gonna go to war with in case shit happens. But then you have the feminists, and along with the alphabet mafia, they're like trying to feminize men. They're trying to constantly destroy masculinity. Writing children's books called My Princess Boy. And then, oh, you don't listen to us. That means you must be gay. Hold on. Somebody wants to talk. Hold on. Let me share the screen. And hopefully he doesn't say something dumb. Hold on. Me. Share the screen. All right, what you got to say?
What are we talking about? You just were ranting, bro. I just want to know what we're talking about.
Oh, well, there was this essay that was written back in 1983.
Just give me the short story.
Okay.
I just want to know the short story.
Basically, this feminist is saying that...
The shortest story.
Kiss my ass. So anyways, just... All right. All right. So, yeah. So they're constantly with the bullshit. They constantly want to destroy masculinity. Constantly with this bullshit. Here, wear a dress. It's not feminine. That gender doesn't exist. Oh, you can change your gender. Gender's not a thing. Like, yeah. Oh, we don't listen to women. You must be gay. Like, I mean, I like, look, personally, I don't listen to women. I don't. Because a lot of times they got nothing intelligent to say. They really don't. And I'm sorry. I don't trust women at all. I don't. I don't trust women to give me the correct information. There may be only one or two that I might trust on the planet, but the rest, yeah, no. Because a lot of times, like, I don't trust the words of a woman that I'm dating, because it's all about herself, her needs. That's all she's always going to talk about is It's all about her needs. That's why I don't trust what she says. She'll always try to get you into some bullshit. She'll get into an argument with another dude. In fact, I've seen a TikTok where, it's supposed to be a joke, but it happens all the time. This dude, he's with his girl. He's passing by a stoop and they start hollering at her. And he's like saying, look, it's 5-1. I'm going to die if they jump me. So, hey, he keeps going. She turns around and starts arguing with him. And then he's the one that gets fucked up. That's why I don't listen to women at all. I don't. They have nothing intelligent to say. They never have anything to say. And they always have some stupid comment. They always have some stupid comment to say. And they think they're so fucking clever. Like you know, if I was to come across a woman and I said something, well, you're fat. I'm like, yeah, and? You have a new form of gonorrhea that has yet to be discovered because you're such a whore. But then this dumb bitch, Marilyn Fry, who's a philosopher, not even a psychiatrist, not even a therapist, nothing, just someone that talks shit. Marilyn Fry, the person that wrote the Politics of Reality, excerpts from an essay in feminist theory, a feminist philosopher, meaning a broke bitch who apparently people listen to because it sounds makes me feel good. See, the difference between men and women is we do shit, even if it doesn't feel good, we do it because it is the logical thing to do, and we have to do it even if it fucking hurts us. It is what we do. But women, no matter if you tell them the solution to their problem, I don't want to do it. It doesn't feel good. Like, what else is there? I don't know. Why are you always hanging out with your friends? I don't know. I want to hang out with somebody that's fucking intelligent that maybe will help me with a problem with something some practical information. Not because it feels good. Like, no, I'm sorry. I'm going to hang out with the boys. I'm going to discuss my problems with the boys because they'll have a logical solution. I'm not going to go to my girlfriend, my wife, my mother, nothing, because they're going to tell me some flowery bullshit about, maybe, screaming to the moon, howling at the moon. And maybe Khonshu, the god of death, will come down and bless me with some wisdom. Like, shut the fuck up. I'm just trying to fucking change the tire and the fucking bolt is fucking stuck. Give me the fucking WD-40. Doesn't feel good. Can't you use something else? WD-40 is this. Like, shut the fuck up. Oh, you always hang out with the guys. You must be gay. No, because... and look, I guess fine. It's all you're good for is sex. I hate to say this, and it's the fucking reality of the fucking thing. It's the fucking reality because honestly, I can't tell you my fucking problems because what you do, you fucking run to your crackheaded friends. You fucking throw that shit back in my face if we have a fight. The moment, if I tell you my problems, you lose respect for me. You lose respect for me. And then, hey, you want to cheat on me with the first dude that fucking cracks you across the lips. Because that's exactly what you want, but doesn't feel good. Oh, why won't you open up to me? Because it's none of your fucking business. That's why. Because I don't trust you to, like, help me with my problems. I'm sorry, I don't. Just suck my dick and just be happy I'm staying in the house until Friday when I want to go and get a beer with the guys and talk shit about you. Doesn't mean I'm gay. Like, I love you. I just don't like you. just be glad I'm paying your bills. Stop breaking my balls. Anyways, let me play this quick clip this is from a TikTok. And it's called, "What Does It Mean to Be a Man?" Share. Oops.
Mean to be a man.
It means that no matter what you do, it's never good enough. We're supposed to pay for dinner. We're supposed to open doors for them. We're supposed to help them carry heavy stuff. We're supposed to call them ma'am. And nowadays, that's insulting. It means your mental health does not fucking matter. Male suicides make up 3 times the amount of female suicides. I was in the hospital for 11 days on suicide watch. They put me in counseling for maybe 2 months, and then they just sent me on my way. And guys don't open up about their problems because nobody fucking cares. You're just told to get up and walk it off. So why even bother opening up about it, right? It means every time you meet a woman, she automatically thinks that you could possibly be a predator and they have to carry pepper spray and tasers to defend themselves against you. No matter how good we are, a woman could easily just divorce us, take half our money and our kids. If you're unhappy in a relationship, that's your own damn problem. But if a woman's unhappy in a relationship, that's also your fucking problem. Basically, you better be able to provide or you're a loser.
What does it mean to be a man?
It means that no matter what you do, it's never good enough.
Right, yeah. Isn't that not the truth? It's like, you know, why do we open, why should we open up to you? Why shouldn't we? It really makes no sense. It's like, yeah, of course we're going to hang out with the guys. The guys have practical information. The guys know that, you know, having a mentor, a male mentor, you know, he's been through it. He knows he's coming from a common sense way. I gotta stop watching. So, I mean, but the thing is, this is all this is. It's like, and then, I mean, the reason why I'm bringing it up, yeah, it was written back in 1983. But it's like the alphabet mafia, feminism, they continue to do this because they do like masculinity. And men learn masculinity from who? Other men. And you don't want other men, you don't want males learning how to be masculine men, to learning how to take care of, basically taking care of Western society. I mean, they always try to like make everything is like, oh, it's homoerotic. It's like, no. So what? So, I mean, that, we could turn it around. It's like, okay, you like to go hang out with the girls. That means what? Like, you guys munching box? Like, what the fuck? I mean, probably because most women are fucking cannibalistic when it comes to that bullshit. It's like, oh, why wouldn't you want to hang out with the guys? Because, I don't know. You want to hang out with the guys all the time. Hey, you don't want to hang out with me. Well, maybe be fucking more interesting. Maybe have some fucking common sense. Maybe be fucking trustworthy, because at this point, I can't trust you. Because you'll send me to my doom and then just fuck my best friend. It's like, you'll fucking send me off to, like, oh, he said something bad about me. He yelled at me. He cursed me out. Oh, go fight him. Oh, shit. He's with 10 dudes. Okay, I'm dead. Oh, she didn't even show up at my funeral? What she's doing? Oh, she's already fucking the guy that killed me. Nice, thanks. Love the loyalty. But I'm gay because I want to hang out with the guys. Oh, I'm gay because I learned what I know from other men. I learned how to change the tire. I learned how to fix this from a man. But, oh, that makes me gay somehow. Like, can someone explain that to me? Can someone fucking explain that to me? But hey, they hate masculinity because if there were no masculine men, they could allow this fucking New World Order agenda to continue going. They are allowed this New World agenda to the Great Reset. The only reason why the Great Reset hasn't started is because we are fucking saying, no, fuck you. Hold on. I got somebody wants to say something. Let me put up his volume. Yeah, what's up?
Yo, what's up? Yeah, I was gonna say, fuck transgender people.
Okay, I wasn't even talking about transgender people, but okay.
But yeah, I think you'd agree with that.
Well, I don't have sex with transgender people.
Exactly, because they're fucking useless.
Okay. That's not the point, but okay. You weren't here at the start of the show. Basically talking about how there was this feminist writer back in 1983. She basically says that since we don't listen to women, we don't like to listen to women, we don't do what they say, and we like to hang out with the guys that we learn from men, we respect men, that makes us homosexual for some reason.
So wait, question.
Yes, dear.
Do you like Andrew Tate?
Yeah, he's all right.
Do you agree with the things he says?
Most of them, yeah.
So you're a real one. So that's when I say goodbye to you and have a good rest of your life.
All right. Salam alaikum. All right. So, yeah, with that, I mean, honestly, my only thing is don't allow them to say, oh, well, don't allow them to shame you from not learning from your brothers, not learning from the older men. Like, because in every society, the old wise men in the tribe passes down their information to the younger males. That's just how it is. And that's how we learn. We get our knowledge passed down from other males. You didn't learn to hunt from the woman. You didn't learn how to fight and kill from a woman. You learned all that, all the knowledge you need to learn to live, to fight and even die. You learned it from the older men of the tribe. And honestly, in fact, also in when it comes to like fighting sports, like mixed martial arts, like boxing, all that. You learn, there's usually a maestro, a teacher that teaches you these things. And whoever tries to help you advance yourself as a person, as a man, you naturally grow respect for that person. You naturally grow respect But when you learn, you grow respect, you grow reverence for that person because you've learned. They're actually helping you advance. They're helping you advance in the fight game, in growing your knowledge. Like, yeah, you're going to have respect for that person that has given you this knowledge, that especially if it's free, he's giving it to you for free, the free knowledge for you to learn how to fight, kill, die. It's like, you know, of course you're going to have respect for that person. These are skills that you're not going to learn from women because it doesn't feel good. It's just, I'm sorry. I mean, you don't learn sacrifice from women. You don't. I mean, hold on. What is that quote from Clark Gable? Clark Gable, actually, this is one of my favorite quotes. And it's like, I've never, here it is. I mean, the thing a man has to have are hope and confidence in himself against odds. And he must be ready to choose death before dishonor without making too much song and dance about it. And that's by Clark Gable. Let's break that down. Our hope and confidence in himself, because at the end of the day, that's all he has. I mean, choosing death before dishonor. And I truly actually believe this. I actually do believe this. In order for Western society to work, men have to be willing to sacrifice themselves. men have to be willing to be disposable in order for Western society to work, for in order for Western society to advance, to keep going. You need men who are willing to put their lives on the line in defense of society. I don't know why women don't want to be in the I don't know why women want to be in the front lines. They have the superpower to make children. Hang back. But no, you see us, you see the commodity, and you just, we don't trust them on their own. We gotta watch them. We gotta watch them because they might do something. We don't trust them. Well, fuck it. We don't trust you either. Especially nowadays. You're teaming up with the Alphabet Mafia to try to destroy us. We got to form up now. And honestly, look how you guys act with City Girl Summer. City Girl Summer. Okay, you want to be hoes. You want to be fucking hoes. So, sorry, sweetie. That's all you're good for is getting some ass and that's it. Give me my fucking Xbox. Give me some pussy, and after that, I'm going to play my fucking Xbox. No, I don't want to hear about your fucking day because it's fucking retarded. I don't care about your fucking friend and how she fucking sat on a tack or some fucking dumb shit because she's a fucking dumbass. Like, I don't care. Your friends don't like me? Oh, shit. Okay, fine. Fuck you. Fuck them. I don't pay their bills. They don't pay my bills. Wait, are they going to pay your bills? Oh, okay. Then you shut the fuck up too. Honestly, and that's why people are mad at Andrew Tate. They're mad at Andrew Tate. They're mad at Fresh and Fit because it's like, no, you're waking guys up to the game. You're waking guys up to the game, and it's like, and the thing is, the thing that pisses me off is they're so quick to defend the LGBTQ. Yet the moment you do something you don't like, oh, you gay motherfucker, I bet you like sucking dick. I'm like, oh, whoa. You're such a fucking ally, but you want to use that as a weapon. How the fuck does that make sense? Yeah, I'm homophobic when I get upset when you keep constantly trying to accuse me of being gay because I hang out with the guys. Like, explain that shit. I mean, that's pretty fucking homophobic. That's even more homophobic. It's like, oh, he's gay. Oh, he must be gay because he doesn't listen to me. Like, have you said anything that makes any fucking sense? You guys don't want to be led. You guys don't want to follow. And a lot of times, it lacks common sense. It lacks common sense all the time. But I don't know. Well, no, I do know. It's like, look, don't allow them to bully you from being a man. I mean, that's what they try to do. They try to bully you. They're trying to stop masculinity. They try to discourage boys from being boys, which is fucking dangerous, by the way. Which, mind you, is probably going to cause more male suicides towards later in life, because it's like you're denying their nature, because it's like we didn't raise them to be boys. Oh, but weren't they male? The doctor assigned them male. We mean assign the male. Like, what the fuck? Like, this is the shit that's the shit that really fucking pisses me off. Like, they really hate men. It is a war of men on men, but they always want to say, oh, women are being this, when they hate women. Like, first of all, abortion should not be used as a fucking contraceptive. That's common sense. Common sense. But anyways, like to thank everyone for listening to the show today. Be sure to subscribe on iTunes, iHeartRadio, TuneIn Radio. We're also on Anchor.fm. You can check it out there. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe on however you're watching and or listening to this show. And as always, from my house to your house, Bob.
Warning. Oops. Warning.
Nope. Oh.
This show.
All right. Keep fucking it up. All right. I gotta make a closing card for this one. All right. Closing time. All right. So. All right. Bye, everybody.
That's the end of my show. Donk.